Welcome to hardhatengineer.com. I am Varun Patel. In this video, you will learn about the most common questions regarding piping that you may face during the interview. In this video, you will learn about these questions. What is the insulation gasket kit and where do you use it? What is insulation joint? What is the minimum distance to be maintained between two welds in a pipe? What are different types of insulation used in piping? What is the difference between GRE and GRP pipe? What is the difference between post-heating of the weld and PWHT? So if you want to learn about this, please watch this video till the end. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because that way you will get regular updates on new video. You can subscribe right now by just clicking subscribe button on your screen. So let's start with first question. What is insulation gasket kit and where do you use it? The insulation gasket kit is a specially designed gasket package that used to prevent galvanic corrosion of the flange face in piping system when the material of connecting flanges is different. Here in the image, you can see the complete kit of insulation gasket. Basically, it prevents direct metal-to-metal contact of two different flange material. Second question is, what is insulation joint? Insulation joint is used to break the current flow of an underground pipeline that is equipped with cathodic protection. To protect the underground pipeline from corrosion, cathodic protection is used. An external current is supplied to the pipeline. However, if this current flow continues when the line goes above ground, it will damage the pane that applied to protect the above ground pipeline. To avoid this situation, insulation joint is used. It is designed in such a way that it will break the flow of current. Here in the image, you can see the configuration of insulation joint. Third question. What is the minimum distance to be maintained between two welds in a pipeline? No American code and standard mandate the minimum distance between two welds in a pipeline. But most company specification will give you some minimum distance that you have to maintain between two nearby welds. This is to avoid overlapping of heat affected zones. The thumb rule is that the minimum distance between adjacent butt weld is 1 time the diameter of the pipe. If not, it is never closer than 1.5 inch. This is supposed to prevent the overlap of heat affected zone. In the image, you can see that what I am trying to explain to you. Here, two weld joints are shown. The minimum distance between these two joints should be 1 time diameter of the pipe. So if your pipe size is 4 inch NPS, the distance should be 4 inch. If this is not possible, it should not be less than 1.5 inch. Now, the minimum spacing of circumferential weld between center line shall not be less than 4 times the pipe wall thickness or 25 mm, whichever is greater. Here you can see the example. If you have a branch welding on a pipe, then the distance between two adjacent branch or the nearest girth weld should be 4 times the pipe wall thickness or 25 mm, whichever is greater. Please note that these are thumb rules and vary from company to company. Fourth question. What are different type of insulation used in piping? You know that two types of insulation are used in the plant for the conservation of the heat. First is cold insulation with the cryogenic system that prevent heating of the system, and hot insulation that used to protect heat loss to maintain the temperature of the system. Commonly used hot insulation material are shown here in the image. Mineral wool, glass wool, calcium silicate, ceramic fiber, and foam glass. These are the commonly used hot insulation material. In this slide, commonly used cold insulation material are shown. expanded polystyrene form that is known as thermocol, polyurethane form that is known as puff, polyisocyanurate form, foam glass. These are the commonly used cold insulation material. Fifth question is, what is the difference between GRE and GRP pipe? GRP, that is glass fiber reinforced plastic, and GRE, that is glass fiber reinforced epoxy. GRE and GRP pipe are used in seawater and sewage transport application. This pipe offers excellent corrosion resistance property over all other type of pipes. The main difference between GRE and GRP is the resin used for the bonding of the glass fiber. GRP pipe use isopropylic resin, whereas GRE pipe use epoxy resin. GRE pipes are used for the industrial application also, as it can withstand higher temperature compared to GRP pipe. GRE pipe are used in offshore platform and water treatment plant to handle salty waters. The last question of this video is, what is the difference between post-heating of the weld and PWHT? If we know what is post-heating and what is PWHT, you can easily answer this question. In post-heating, you raise the temperature of the weld joint to the predetermined temperature range, usually 250 degree centigrade to 350 degree centigrade, for the minimum period of, that is also usually 3 hours, before the weld cools down to the room temperature. Post-heating perform immediately before weld gets cold, when the welding is completed or terminated, any time in between. Post-heating is also known as dehydrogenation, as it removes the entrapped hydrogen from the weld. Post-heating is done to avoid delayed cracking in the weld. PWHT, that is known as post-weld heat treatment, is performed on the completed weld to relieve the stress from the weld joint. This will soften the heat affected zone and reduce the hardness of the weld. PWHT can be performed anytime after the weld completed. Now you can answer the difference between post-heating and PWHT. Post-heating is used to avoid delay cracking, and PWHT is used to relieve the stress from the joint. This is the end of the video and also the end of the piping interview question series. I hope you have enjoyed the videos in this series. Please do share and like this video with your friends. Don't forget to visit my website hardhatengineer.com to learn more about piping. See you soon. Goodbye. Take care.